What is documentary? In short, the question of what a documentary is, we can say that it's a means of expression that will introduce different social life styles and cultures, and at the same time deal with the problems of the social historical period, in order to educate and inform the public. In the words of Roy Armus, we can call it a means of expression that will make the man on the street play his real life in his real position. Although the producers claim that they convey the real thing in their productions in documentaries, this claim should be evaluated considering that there are different approaches in the documentary genre. Roy Armus classified the perspective of reality in cinema into three groups. In the first approach, which argues that reality has been unveiled, people, objects and human experiences are explained by being aesthetized in front of camera. In the second approach, life is imitated. This imitation brings along narrative. The third tradition is the search and questioning of the underlying reality rather than the superficial transmission of reality. Documentary types. The documentary can be divided into subgenres in itself. In general, we can list these subgenres as follows: nature documentaries, art documentaries, scientific documentaries, and ethnographic documentaries. Flaherty, the representative of the ethnographic approach, revealed the basic principle of documentary approach with his first study. In Nanook of the North, 1922, he lived the lives of the Eskimos with them and tried to capture the story in the flow of life. To achieve this, he used his camera as a detecting tool. Flaherty's importance in documentary cinema is that he can see the relationship established between human and space and re-establish this relationship in these films. In addition to not using written script, Flaherty also laid the foundations for an alternative style of expression to Hollywood cinema, with productions lasting at least 2 years. Emmerich criticized Flaherty's productions that, despite the fact that various human situations are identified at the instant and in the space, these productions are far from the social and political realities of their time. How to make a documentary? Both documentaries and docudramas aim to convey a certain message to the audience, starting from a real subject. Producers and directors who make use of this narrative tool try to make the audience respond to the subject in the production. Unlike the news programmer, the documentary producers try to explain not only what reality is, but also why. At the same time, it tries to examine the factors underlying these reasons one by one in all dimensions. At this point, the importance of the researcher side of the documentary producers emerges. Budget is one of the factors that constrain the producers in the research phase. But as Williams and D'Arienzo point out, no matter how tight the budget is, the producers cannot escape the responsibility of an ineducated research. During the research phase, producers must enter the subject sufficiently to develop their point of view. Through the materials that will form the basis of the production, the truth is reconstructed as a result of the producer's perspective and material preferences. Documentaries today. Today, documentaries, which are considered to be the recording and interpretation of historical, social, cultural values and lifestyles that are little known or have not been processed until now, attract attention, especially outside the society in which they are produced. The audience prefers to follow the cultural values and concrete social practices of different societies. The growing interest in television documentaries is a fact that attracts the attention of communicators and cultural sociologists. Producers are also aware of this growing interest. While the producers continue to inform the public to support this function of the productions with an aestheticized expression. Regardless of the subgenres of the documentary, our domestic documentary productions deal with the cultural values. life practices and human relations of Turkish society to convey that what a young documentary filmmaker, John Reed, thinks about the documentary can be enlightening in this regard. For whatever reasons a person makes films about art and artists, someone else can make films about ship and shipbuilders for the same reasons. Regardless of whether the documentary producer is about a practice, object, region, person or a situation of the society, he always opens the lens of the camera, seeing the aim as real. It is trying to make the audience open their eyes to real definition that they do. Documentary film features and production principles. Documentary film, documentation which is a requirement of science, aesthetics which is a requirement of art, and fiction as a requirement of the film are the elements that documentary film brings together and integrates. Documentation, the real side of life. Aesthetics, the beautiful side of life. Fiction also expresses the order of life. There can be nothing without a past. Documentation, they are stories, determinations, truths, wrongs, those who have a past. Documents are the most important material of documentary cinema. The word documentary, which differs from other genres and most distinctly refers to an approach towards non-fiction filmmaking. To define what a documentary film is, it is necessary to address and conditions in cinema at the time this genre emerged, because these conditions will also give information about the reasons and which elements the documentary cinema was created. According to Paul Roth, every trend in cinema reflects the social and political structure of the period. There are one way or another a reflection of the current economic conditions. The documentary method, which is different type of film, means social sensation and philosophical ideas, and the interpretation of story films a little different from the entertainment world. Sinclair wrote, "The era before World War I calls that film industry a symbol of escapism from contemporary realities." However, as World War I was a period when people were confronted with economic and political realities, there was a dynamism in the direction in cinema. The First World War caused people to make the place of the desire to escape, to know the world we live in and to climb its problems. The combination of the documentary filmmaker's ability to record the earth as close to reality with this request is one of the important factors in the development of documentary cinema. Moreover, the unique characteristics of the documentary filmmaker have led to the use of this device in scientific research. If we add some of the efforts of the selfies, we can see that a very wide-ranging orientation has begun in order to cinema to move outside the narrative film field. The cinema, which has a number of functions in many fields ranging from nature research to biology and microbiology studies, has ceased to be just a form of storytelling. Since the documentary film is based on the realities in society, it is unthinkable that the realities stay away from the society in which they live. Therefore, it has been affected by social change in the historical process. It also had an impact of what happened in the social sphere. The Second World War greatly influenced the documentary film structure. The rapid spread of the mechanization of production and distribution was decisive in this. Documentaries can now be a propaganda tool for war alone. In addition, the fact that documentaries can fulfill a function that will protect people's unity and solidarity and instill trust in them has started to be evaluated in England and Canada. This function is mostly for peace purposes. How are we fighting? Series such as documentaries carry the data of the Second World War. After the war, a historical preparatory meeting was held in June 1947. Here a manifesto for the World Onion was put forward in the field of documentary. A year later, the Onion will hold its first and only meeting in Czechoslovakia. Here, A documentary definition is made under which 14 nations have signed. Documentary film, interpretation of any appearance of reality, with all methods of recording on celluloid, creating a sense of reason with shots or formations based on events, expanding human knowledge and understanding economy, culture, and to offer solutions for human relations and produce productions and stimulate. According to Sedat Cerci, the documentary film is full charm and detailed structure. Documentary is opposite of entertainment types that take away from reality and has a structure that is formed and reflects the intensity and complexity of life. For some, the documentary is neither about a situation nor a particular moment. Documentary is life itself with all its features. Documentary films, a style based on document reality, a broad category of visual expression. John Grierson, one of the important directors of the British documentary film school, and the documentary film director that directs the documentary film, describes the documentary film concisely. According to Grierson, documentary film is creative processing of reality. According to John Grierson, the main principles of documentary cinema are 1. We believe that we will find a new and vital art form in cinemas, ability to look at the environment, to observe and extract the events of real life. Those who shot movies in studios do not know the possibilities of taking the curtain the real world. They just take pictures of some things in front of artificial decorations. 2. We believe that local actor and local scene are the best guides to interpret the modern world. 3. We believe that the topics and materials found on the spot are much more beautiful than those found through acting. Against Flaherty, who says that fighting for food in a wild environment is a very noble thing. You can rightly see that the problems of the people fighting the bread in an abundant environment concern you more. Although like a symphony, even though they have been successfully edited, everyday little things are not enough. In order to reach the climax of art, it is necessary to reach creativity beyond the process of showing what happened. In the light of this distinction, creativity means creating values, not creating certain things. This sense of social responsibility makes documentary cinema a realistic, difficult, and disturbing art. Zahur Mukarrem says, in the documentary we see the unbreakable connection of the three elements. These, the possibilities of detecting the reality taking place in front of camera, are the personal interpretation of the artists and the description of the reality formed by the term of these two. While the contents of the documentary constitute real cases, the meaning of the content must be formed by the spirit of the artist and understanding. The attitude of the artist can be filled or hidden in the shots obtained in accordance with his purpose. According to Cerci, documentary film can be considered as a special genre in terms of its quality, because documentary, unlike other film genres, requires more intense research, objective perspective and artistic concern, as well as proximity to real subjects. Documentary film is completely different and far from the theatrical tradition seen in narrative film. The documentary filmmaker supports the reality of these events by taking advantage of the way of watching, seeing, and hearing in each film, influenced by a social event. The social events that the producer is affected by emerge from the facts about the society he lives in. So, the producer must use his observation ability. He should know very well how to listen, see, and feel. Social problems are one of the important subject areas of documentary films. It is necessary to determine the cultural, social, and aesthetic attitudes of the society. According to Simten Gündeş, the documentary film derives its material and method from the environment it is in. It records the events that have happened or are happening in an aesthetic way by using the possibilities of the art of cinema with its own objective framework. The features of this registration or processing can be listed as follows. The filmmaker examines his age and important problems of society by collecting all relevant information and conducting on-site research. After the subject is well understood, a draft is prepared. The film takes place where the subject takes place or in a similar environment. Documentary film aims to reflect any problem and the underlying truth, tries to remain objective while reflecting this fact. Despite the efforts of objectivity, the film is shaped according to the understanding, worldview, and knowledge of the documentary filmmaker. Documentary filmmaker expresses the truth he wants to reflect not in a dry document, but without distorting its original, but by taking advantage of the possibilities of cinema and makes it effective. Images and descriptions should have a clarity that can be easily understood by everyone. In other way, the documentary filmmaker can explain his personal attitude towards the problem and its reason in order to influence the audience in a certain way. The general purpose of the documentary is to reveal the problems, to search for and find solutions. The documentary film covers every work that makes a serious attempt to make a contemporary interpretation of the problems, real personalities and way of living of people anywhere on earth. The main material of the documentary film is the facts about the human being. Documentary film realizes the recording of the existing with the criteria of being art. Documentaries are criticized by the creative use of the cinematic tool and substance. Spatial uses of realities have been exploited, not their artificiality. This is not a rushed method. In my opinion, the documentary method is not a method that can only be described once. Documentary film can only achieve success by conveying the thoughts of the producers about society and individuals to the audience. Therefore, the documentary film should be the voice of people speaking from their homes, factories, and fields. The fact that the raw material of documentary cinema is observable indicates that it can be perceived essentially by everyone except for the people in the production process. In other words, the events already exist outside of the documentarian's presence. Thus, like a documentary scientist, he cannot remain objective and look outside, because he is observing a social life that he is an a part of. He observes with his own understanding of life, emotions, culture, in other words, everything that makes the documentary filmmaker human. In this sense, the documentaries who observes from outside cannot be natural, impartial, and objective. To suggest the opposite means putting the documentary filmmaker apart from the human being who is a part of social life. At this point, let's remember John Grierson's definition of documentary cinema, which is widely accepted all over the world: the creative treatment of actuality. Here, it is necessary to underline an important point. The documentary film as a film processes its material, but this operation, interpretation, does not mean to distort the form of what is reality in not mean to distort the form of the what is. What is reality in social? It is the presentation of reality in artistic form. Documentary filmmaker brings life itself to the audience. In documentary cinema, bringing small items in old cities, monuments, all kinds of architectural works and museums to the wide screen or television screen. It is an important phenomenon that was born at the crossroads of the technological and aesthetic values created by the human beings. As it can be understood, this phenomenon is a contemporary phenomenon that simultaneously engages both an informative concern with practical value and creative activity appealing to the emotions. In short, documentary method has a more complex structure than the traditions imposed on us. It is not contented with only pictorial descriptions of people and objects. Observation alone is not enough. The motion picture of the cinema may be based on aesthetically good observation. However, the most important purpose of the documentary is to reveal the findings obtained and the end of the observations. Efforts are made to present the results in a creative way. Under the external experience of the modern world lies the activation of the economic fabric of civilization. These are the true purposes of purposeful documentaries. only superficial descriptions of the facts in industry, trade, civilization and nature are not sufficient. Such superficial depictions lack intellectual capability. Documentaries must fulfill more important goals. In the documentary method, every organization, every function, every shame is related to the human being. Documentary film function. Documentaries serve a specific purpose. This may be due to a propaganda requirement, or it may be in the form of revealing the surface of modern experiences. For example, when we consider the use of documentary for dialectical purpose, it may be possible to get down to the sources of our today's heritage. The various views are dramatically highlighted by documentaries. The basic sensations in the human mind can be analyzed and fragmented for multiple purposes. All aspects of modern thought can be explained with documentary methods. After clearer analysis, definitive conclusions are reached. Documentary film has many functions. It is possible to collect these functions in three different time periods. It has functionality in the context of yesterday, today, and tomorrow, such as looking at the past from today, recording the present, and building a bridge to tomorrow with today's record. Our documents and documentary films are proof that our culture, our view of the world, and our art exist as long as the same documents are preserved. They may have chance to become the words of other cultures, other thoughts, other films after a while. Conscious of the fact that artists are people who produce, not consumers, we can assume that abundant ones will come to life in new productions. The functions of documentation can be evaluated in this context in historical, artistic and social terms. The documentary filmmaker who produces using the document material also has historical responsibility in this sense. In addition to general responsibility definitions, the most important of our individual and concrete responsibilities is to protect our documents and documentaries and make them available for all kinds of required fields. One of the most important functions of the documentary film is that it helps us to understand life as a whole. It is to present the perspective of the society in which we live. The perspective can also be on living conditions or on the cultural conditioning of society. The importance of documentary film. Since the term documentary expresses meanings such as about documents, consisting of documents, based on documents, its usage is not only about cinema. Documentary film, on the other hand, is a branch of art that has a separate place in cinema and is divided into various subgenres. There are two important elements in the formation of documentary film. Documentary filmmaker is an artist who produces a work using these two important elements. Documentary film aims to activate both material and emotional activities of people. This purpose is achieved by expressing the reality of life through art. Documentary film is the reality of the world we live in. It is life itself. Documentary films are all methods of recording an aspect of reality that is interpreted through constructing faithfully on film in a way that appeals to the mind or emotions. According to faithfulness, the reality is the distinguishing and therefore indispensable feature of the documentary. Documents, which are the source of documentary cinema, serve as a material documentary films and mediate the transfer of ever-changing and finding values to the next generations, thus keeping the social memory alive. In other words, documents waiting in dusty shelves, archives, or parts of life that we look but cannot see every day, come into being with the spirit the documentary filmmaker brings to them and brings to speak. If we are dealing with cinema, especially documentary cinema, documenting should come up as an obligation, such as drinking water, eating, and sleeping. Moreover, it should be as instinctive as breathing. Even though we pass through the same streets every day, we should consider it our duty to document and accumulate change, existence, disappearance, instant events, being aware that we pass through the same streets every day. Documents are the most important material of documentary cinema. While we are making documentary films, we add new documents to the memories. Documentary filmmakers say that they are aware of their responsibility of being a social memory ambassador who observes, records, and transmits the past and the present to the future with their approach that investigates the past and future of events and situations. The way to create social memory is to collect memories, information, and documents about human lives. It is collecting sound and photos. What's more is to collect details. Documentary filmmakers' job is to interpret our accumulations with aesthetic values without prejudice. The documentary filmmaker has an endless field of freedom. It does not have difficulty in choosing the subject. Every nature has material that produces itself. In this endless process, following from nature to man, from man to time, the documentary filmmaker will not fail to the person questioning the age. As a result, documentary cinema is the projection of the day we live in our recent history. The sentence written is a photograph taken and the documentary cinema, which is increasingly the most powerful expansion of memory. This sub-branch of the seventh art, where arts meet life and life with history, deserves enough attention. The documentary takes the subject of the film from the human and life. Documentation required by science, aesthetics required by art, and function required by the film are the elements that documentary film brings together and integrates. Documentation, the real side of life. Aesthetics, the beautiful side of life. Function also expresses the order of life. When Robert Flaherty was filming Nanook of the North in The North People in 1922, no doubt he could not imagine that the documentary film would one day be a genre that evolved with a different structure and potency than other thematic films. In the following years, the documentary film, which manifested itself an indispensable part of cinema and then television, would follow a success line that often went beyond dramas in its ever-expanding realistic, new and artistic framework. The strength of the original structure of the documentary stems from its closeness to the realities, its openness to research and innovation, and even its artistic character. Yes, the documentary film was realistic and also about the events we live through. Documentary movie, it covered man and history, human problems, his social life, philosophy of life, politics, changing attitudes, and everything about man. The closeness to the human and the human reality in the documentary highlighted it more than a functionalized production made with dreams and integrated its impact. Documentary film differs from functional films with its content, approach to the subject and artistic concerns, as well as the formation of the script and its script writing features. The scenario is the basic starting point of the film in the documentary film, but the elements that determine the flow of the subject in the documentary film script, the climaxes and the style of voiceover are different. Now we are watching a documentary. The documentary is Nanook of the North, one of the most important works of documentary cinema. It is about Norton Nanook. Original name Nanook of the North is a 1922 Robert J. Flaherty movie. It is considered one of the most important examples of documentary cinema. Flaherty conveying the lifestyle, hunting and daily lives of Eastern Canadian Inuit Eskimos, who lived far from technology and everything in those days. It was the subject of primitive man's war and reconciliation with the natural environment he lived in, and he visualized what actually exists. The name of the film comes from the Eastern Canadian Inuktitut word Nanook, which means polar bear.
Thank you.
Thank you.